নিতাই পাদ কামল কোটি চন্দ্র সুশীতল,
নিতাই পাদ কামল কোটি চন্দ্র সুশীতল,
নিতাই পাদ কামল কোটি চন্দ্র সুশীতল,
নিতাই পাদ কামল
যেথায় জগত জোড়া, যেথায় জগত জোড়া, হেনে তাই বিনে ভাই রাধা কৃষ্ণ পাইতে না,
নিতাই বিনে ভাই রাধা কৃষ্ণ পাইতে না,
রেঢ়া করে ধরো নিতাই পাদ,
রেঢ়া করি ধরো নিতাই পাদ,
রেঢ়া করে ধরো নিতাই পাদ,
রেঢ়া করে ধরো নিতাই পাদ,
সে সম্বন্ধ নাহি যাত মৃতা জন্ম গেল তার,
সে সম্বন্ধ নাহি যাত মৃতা জন্ম গেল তার,
সে পশু বড় দুরা
সে পশু বড় দুরাচার,
সে পশু বড় দুরাচার,
সে পশু বড় দুরাচার,
নিতাই না বলিল মুখে মারিল সংসার সুখে,
নিতাই না বলিল মুখে মারিল সংসার সুখে,
বিদ্যা কুলে কি করিবে তার,
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 অহংকারে মত্ত হইয়া নিতাই পদ পাসরিয়া,
অহংকারে মত্ত হইয়া নিতাই পদ পাসরিয়া,
অসত্যের সত্য করি মানি,
অসত্যের সত্য করি মানি,
অসত্য রে সত্য করি মানি,
অসত্য রে সত্য করি মানি,
নিতাই করুণা হবে राधे राधा कृष्ण पवे
गाये करुणा हवे राजे राधा कृष्ण पवे
घरनिताय शरण दुखानी
घरनिताय चरण दुखानी
घरनिताय चरण दुखानी
घरनिताय चरण दुखानी
नेतायेर चरण सत्य सहर सेवक नित्य
नेताये चरण सत्य ताहर सेवक नित्य
नेताय पद सदा करो आशा
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 नारतम बड़ दुखी नेताय मोरे करो दुखी
नारतम बड़ दुखी नेताय मोरे करो सुखी
राखरंगा चरणे रपास
राखो रंगा चरणे रपास
राखो रंगा चरणे रपास
राखो रंगा चरणे रपास
हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा कृष्णा हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण हरे राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम राम राम
हरे गौर हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल कै गौर हरि बोल
हे कै गौर हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल कै गौर हरि
भय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद
जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद
जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद
जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद
जय जय नित्यानंद
जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद
जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद
जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद
जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद
जय जय नित्यानंद
जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद
जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्त वृंद
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 पावन हरिनाम संकीर्तन की
जय।
अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की
जय।
श्रील प्रभुपाद की
जय।
समावेत भक्त वृंद की
जय।
चैतन्य चरितामृत की
जय।
ज्ञानांजन शलाकया चक्षुः उन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपकदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकं। वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरोः श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवं साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगणललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च। नमावों विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादी पाश्चात्यदेशतारिणे वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंद। हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर द चैतन्य चरितामृत Chapter 15. We have come to the last section of the chapter, which is Lord Chaitanya accepting Prasad at Sarvabhauma's house. In the last class, we saw the charitable disposition of Sarvam Bhattacharya and his desire to host all the associates of Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu along with Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu on different days, different sannyasis and the associates of Mahaprabhu coming to his home. Practically the whole month was packed with schedules of different people visiting his home on different days. That was very thrilling to see the Sarvam Bhattacharya's disposition of ideal grihastha, who never fears to open the door for the saintly people to come and take prasadam. Shatira Mata, wife of Sarvam Bhattacharya, is also a very great cook. And can you imagine, a lady is told to cook for the whole month, every day some 2 or 4 or 6 sannyasi guests are coming to home. Once in a blue moon, if some sannyasi visits to home once in 6 months, people are very happy. But every day, imagine if you get guests at your home. So in this day and age, Kali Yuga, it is said the householders should organize sankirtan in their home and invite all the devotees to their home and have a deity and have nice sankirtan and lecture by some saintly people. So many times the grihasthas fear that if we put up a program in our home, who will cook the prasadam? Or we may have to cater, do some catering from the Govindas or something like that. It becomes easy to do catering. Just make a phone call, order, and then prasadam arrives at your home. And also many people are not ready to open the doors of the house because, you know, you lose your privacy, you lose your time, the evening would be lost and you have many other important busy things to do. But traditionally speaking, if a Vaishnava householder wants to advance in spiritual life, they should be willing to open the doors for, tens of Vaishnavas to come to their home, clap hands and do sankirtan, worship the deity and attend a lecture by saintly people. And then they should be fed with sumptuous prasadam and they will give ashirvad and go, blessings. Then the family will flourish in their devotional service. So here is a very shining example of Sarvam Bhattacharya and his good wife, Satira Mata. And they are cooking huge feasts for saintly people for one full month in their home. In fact, Bhattacharya was inviting Mahaprabhu to come to his home for how long? 30 days in the beginning.
Then he reduced to 20 days, then 15 days, then 10 days. Then Mahaprabhu said only 1 day. Finally, it was agreed that he'll come for 5 days. So it goes to show, imagine, if Mahaprabhu came for 1 month and associates came for 1 month, it would be 2 months. And Bhattacharya was ready for it. Correct, no? Which goes to show that daily he wanted to serve prasad to saintly people. So, just as brahmacharis are told that daily you should study Bhagavatam, Bhagavad Gita. Like that, grihastha should be very eager to serve daily also. That kind of example they are setting. Now, let's go further now. 204 verse number.
Pakashalara dakshine dui bhogalaya. Ekagare shalagramera bhogasevahaya. On the southern side of the kitchen were two rooms for offering food, and in one of them the food was offered to Shalagram Narayan. Among the followers of the Vedic way, the Shalagram Shila, the Vigra of Narayan, is worshipped in the form of a stone ball. In India, every Brahmana still worships the Shalagram Shila in his home. The Vaishyas and Kshatriyas may also engage in this worship, but it is compulsory in the house of a Brahmana.
Yeah. Every Brahmana's home had a Shaligram Shila, which is Vishnu and the Purusha Sukta prayers, Tulasi, Gangajal. There is a special type of worship which has to be done.
Aragara Mahaprabhura Bhikshara Lagiya. Nibrute Kariyache Bhatta Nutana Kariya. The other room was for Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's lunch. The Lord's lunch room was very secluded, and it was newly constructed by the Bhattacharya.
Yeah. So that Mahaprabhu can take in that room, and the others will take in the other room.
Bahye Yeka Dwara Tara Prabhu Praveshite. Pakashalara Yeka Dwara Anna Pariveshite. The room was so constructed that there was only one door opening on the outside, which served as an entrance for Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. There was another door attached to the kitchen, and it was through this door that the food was brought.
Yeah, I'll show you the picture. Here it comes. You can see this. You are seeing this? In this picture you see, here Mahaprabhu is taking prasad here. And who is sitting at the entrance? Sarvabhattacharya. And this is the outer. So, and in this room here, Shatir Mata is standing. This is the kitchen. So she will cook here and give to Mahaprabhu here. Immediately Prabhuji will serve. And there is no other interference. In another separate room, another place, other devotees are taking. So that when Mahaprabhu is eating, nobody can put their eye. It's a little private place. Like that's what is explained here.
Bhattisha Atiya Kalara Angatiya Pate. Tena mana tandulera ubarila bhate. First 3 manas of cooked rice, almost 6 pounds, was poured onto a big banana leaf. This is the beginning of a description of the food prepared for Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
From 208.
This description is given by Kaviraj Goswami, who it is assumed was an expert cook who knew both how to prepare and how to serve food.
So from here I will not read the verses, because ओके दिस वाज वी विल रीड पीत सुगंधि घृते अन्न सिक्त कैल चारिदिके पाते घृत वही याचलिल
Then the whole stack of rice was mixed with so much yellowish and fragrant clarified butter that it began to overflow the leaf.
Yeah. We can read only the translations now. Read it.
There were a number of pots made of the bark of banana trees and leaves of the kea plant. These pots were filled with various cooked vegetables and placed on all sides of the leaf.
Very Vedic. There are plant we make now with the banana leaf also we make. Yeah.
There were about 10 kinds of spinach.
Ten kinds of spinach. Yeah.
A soup called shukta, which was made with bitter nimba leaves. A pungent preparation made with black pepper. A mild cake made of fried curd and a butter milk mixed with small fried pieces of dal.
Then.
There were preparations of dugdha tumbi, dugdha kushmanda, vesar, lapara, mocha ghant, mocha bhaja, and other vegetables.
You know the name, no? Yeah. Yeah. Yes?
There were unlimited quantities of vrida kushmanda.
Vrida kushmanda. Badi.
Badi. Full badi, fruits and various roots.
Badi means what is it? From dal is made. They make it. They make a strip like this.
It's in the shape of a
laddu.
And they put it in some vegetables.
And yes.
Very tasty.
That is called
badi.
Okay. Yeah.
Other preparation included eggplant mixed with newly grown nimba leaves fried together.
Baingan, na?
Light badi, fried patola, and fried rounds of squash and pumpkin.
Yeah.
There was a soup made with fried urad dal and mung dal, defeating nectar. There were also sweet chutney and 5 or 6 kinds of sour preparation, beginning with bada mala. There were badas made of mung dal and of urad dal and of sweet bananas, and there were sweet rice cakes, coconut cakes, and various other cakes. There were kanji bada, dugdha chida, dugdha laklaki,
yeah,
and various cakes that I am unable to describe. Sweet rice mixed with ghee was poured into an earthen pot and mixed with champa kala, condensed milk, and mango. Other preparations included a various delicious churned yogurt and a variety of sandesh sweetmeats.
Indeed, all the various eatables available in Bengal and Orissa were prepared.
Thus, the Bhattacharya prepared a great variety of food and spread a fine cloth over a white wooden platform. On two sides of the stack of food were pitchers filled with scented cold water. The flowers of the tulsi trees were placed atop the mound of rice. Sarvam Bhattacharya also included several types of food that had been offered to Lord Jagannath. These included sweet balls known as Amrit Guttika, sweet rice and cakes. All these were kept separate. Although the remnants of food left by Jagannath were brought into the Bhattacharya's house, they were kept separate from the preparations he had made at his home. It sometimes happened that prasadam is mixed with a larger quantity of food and then distributed. But in this case, we find that the Sarvam Bhattacharya kept the Jagannath Prasadam separate. He kept it aside particularly for the satisfaction of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. When everything was ready, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu came there alone after finishing his midday duties. He knew the heart of a Sarvam Bhattacharya.
So the word alone is used by, because Bhattacharya said that, please don't bring Swarup Damodar also, because Swarup Damodar comes at other times also. It's not that he comes only with you. Sometimes he comes with you, sometimes he comes separately also. I invite him. And also he said, I have already made a schedule for all the sannyasis on different days. But basically, ultimately, what he wanted to tell Mahaprabhu was, today's prasadam I want to give exclusively for you. Therefore, the word alone is used. Bhattacharya kailatabe pada prakshalana garera bitare gela karite bhojana.
After Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya washed the Lord's feet, the Lord entered the room to take his lunch.
Annadi dekhiya Prabhu vismita hayya. Bhattacharya kahe kichu bhangi kariya.
Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was a little astonished to see the gorgeous arrangement and gesturing. He spoke to Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya.
Alokika ye sab anna vyanjana.
Alokika ye sab anna vyanjana.
Dui prahara bhitare kaiche haila randana.
This is most uncommon. How was this arrangement of rice and vegetable finished within 6 hours?
He's asking, so much is cooked in just 6 hours by your wife? How is it
possible?
Shata chulaya shata jana paka yadi kare. Tabu shigra yeta dravya randi tena pare. Even if 100 people cook in 100 stoves, still so early, within 6 hours, nobody can cook so much quantity of food, like that he is saying, yeah, such a short time. Krishnera bhoga lagayacha anumana kari.
Krishnera bhoga lagayacha anumana kari.
Upare dekhiye yate tulasi manjari.
I hope the food has already been offered to Krishna, since I see there are tulsi flowers on it.
Bhagyavan tumi safala tumara udyoga.
Bhagyavan tumi safala tumara udyoga.
Radha Krishna lagayacha eta drisha bhoga.
Radha Krishna lagayacha eta drisha bhoga.
You are most fortunate and your endeavor is successful, for you have offered such wonderful food to Radha Krishna.
Anyera saurabhya varna ati manorama.
Anyera saurabhya varna ati manorama.
Radha Krishna sakshatiha kariyachen bhojana.
Radha Krishna sakshatiha kariyachen bhojana.
The color of the rice is so attractive and its aroma so good that it appears Radha and Krishna have directly taken it.
Tomara bahuta bhagya kata prashamsibha.
Tomara bahuta bhagya kata prashamsibha.
Ami bhagyavan ihara avashesha pava.
My dear Bhattacharya, your fortune is very great. How much shall I praise you? I also am very fortunate to be able to take the remnants of this food.
Krishnera asana pitha rakaha uthaya.
Krishnera asana pitha rakaha uthaya.
More prasada deha bhinna patre te kariya.
More prasada deha bhinna patre te kariya.
Take away Krishna's sitting place and put it aside. Then give me prasadam on a different plate.
Bhattacharya bale prabhu nakarah vismaye.
Bhattacharya bale prabhu nakarah vismaye.
Ekave tahare tahara shaktiye bhoga siddha hai.
Ekave tahare shaktiye bhoga siddha hai.
Sarvabhaum Bhattacharya said, it is not so wonderful, my lord. Everything has been made possible by the energy and mercy of him who will eat the food.
That means whose mercy? Yeah. Udyogana achila mora grihani rarandhane. Uyara shaktiye bhoga siddha sehi taha jane.
My wife and I did not especially exert ourselves in the cooking. He by whose power the food has been prepared knows everything.
यतासने वसीकरह भोजन प्रभु कहे पूज्य कृष्णेर आसन
Now please sit in this place and take your lunch. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu replied, this place is worshipable because it was used by Krishna.
Yeah.
According to etiquette, things used by Krishna should not be used by anyone else. Similarly, things used by the spiritual master should also not be used by anyone else. That is etiquette. Whatever is used by Krishna or the spiritual master is worshipable. In particular, their sitting or eating places should not be used by anyone else. A devotee must be very careful to observe this.
Also, they should be kept in a very respectful manner. Like, you know, bedding of the Lord and plates of the Lord, they're kept in a clean place, they're washed properly. And utmost care has to be taken in that service, because if any offenses, then we suffer also. Huh? A mistake also, we should not sit on them. Bhattakahe anna pitha. समान प्रसाद अन्न कावे पीठे वसिते कहाँ अपराध
द भट्टाचार्य सेड बोथ द फूड एंड द सिटिंग प्लेस आर द लॉर्ड्स मर्सी इफ यू कैन ईट द रेमनेंट्स ऑफ द फूड व्हाट इज द ऑफेंस इन यूर सिटिंग इन दिस प्लेस
प्रभु कहे भाल कैले शास्त्र आज्ञा है कृष्णेर सकल शेष वृत्य आस्वादय
चैतन्य महाप्रभु देन सेड यस यू हैव स्पोकन करेक्टली द शास्त्र एंजॉयज दैट द डिवोटी कैन पार्टेक ऑफ एवरीथिंग लेफ्ट बाय कृष्णा
त्वयोपयुक्त सद्गंध वासोलंकार चर्चिताः उच्चिष्ट भोजिनो दासास् तव मायां जये महि स्वकं दे उद्धव टू कृष्ण ई सेइंग त्वय उपभोक्त स्रगंध वास अलंकार चर्चिताः ई सेइंग माय डियर लॉर्ड कृष्ण दोस गार्लैंड्स वोन बाय यू दोस फ्रैग्रेंसेस एक्सेप्टेड बाय यू एंड द ड्रेसेस वोन बाय यू सो वी एक्सेप्ट द उच्चिष्ट एज डिवोटीज And by accepting those remnants of your food, Tava Mayam Jayamahi, we conquer the illusory energy. Yeah. He is saying that they are all used by your servants later, and then we conquer the illusory energy. And the Hare Krishna movement, the chanting of the Hare Krishna Mahamantra, the dancing in ecstasy, and the eating of the remnants of food offered to Lord are very, very important. One may be illiterate, incapable of understanding the philosophy. But if he partakes of these three items, what are the three items? Prabhupada says, prasadam, chanting and chanting, dancing, prasadam. Well, then he is saying he will certainly be liberated without delay. Was spoken by Uddhava to Lord Krishna. In Uddhava Gita he says that at that time there was some disturbance in Dwaraka, and Lord Krishna decided to leave the material world and enter the spiritual world. Uddhava could understand the situation. And he talked to the Supreme Lord. And the verse quoted above is an excerpt from that conversation. And then Krishna's Leela in this world is called Prakata Leela. And the spiritual world is called Aprakata Leela. Okay. तथापि एतेक अन्न खाओ खाओ नयनायाय बट कहे जाने खाओ यते कजुयाय
श्री चेतन महाप्रभु देन सेड देयर इज सो मच फूड हियर दैट इज इट इज इम्पॉसिबल टू ईट एट ऑल द भट्टाचार्य रिप्लाइड आई नो हाउ मच यू कैन ईट
नीला चले भोजन तुम्हें कर बायान बारा एक एक भोगे रहना शत शत भारा
After all, at Jagannath Puri, you eat 52 times a day, and each time you eat hundreds of buckets filled with prasadam.
Dwarakate shola sahasra mahishi mandire. Ashtadashamatara yadavera ghare.
At Dwarka, you keep 16,000 queens in 16,000 palaces. Also, there are 18 mothers and numerous friends and relatives of the Yadu dynasty.
Vraje Jetha Kuda Mama Pishadi Gopagana. Saka Vrinda Savara Gare. Visandhya Bhojana. So Jetha means fathers, elder brothers, like Nanda Babas, elder brothers, like Upananda and all of them. And Kuda means fathers, younger brothers. So Kuda, Jetha, like that. In Bengali? Correct, yeah. And then Mama means the mother's brothers, maternal uncles. And Pisha means the husbands of aunts.
Yeah.
Adi, so on. So Gopagana, covered man and hundreds of friends you have. Twice a day, all of them eat together.
In Vrindavan, you also have your father's elder brothers, your father's younger brothers, maternal uncles, husband of your father's sister, and many cowherd men. There are also cowherd boyfriends, and you eat twice a day, morning and evening, in the house of each and everyone.
In each and everyone's house. Yeah. I'm probably elaborating that only. See? Radha Krishna Ganodeshtipika says Upananda, Abhinanda. Elder brothers Nanda Maharaj were Upananda and Abhinanda. These are the maternal uncles, Yashodhara, Yashodeva, Sudeva. And the Maharaj sisters. Mahanilaha Sunilash Charamana Vetyoho. So Mahanila and Sunila are the husbands of Krishna's aunts. Govardhana Yagne Anna Kaila Rashi Rashi.
Govardhana Yagne Anna Kaila Rashi Rashi.
Tarele Kaya Yayana Nahe Yeka Grasi. Understood, no? Govardhana ate so much. Now you are just eating one handful, palmful, which is a very small quantity.
Indeed, Sarvam Bhattacharya continue. At the Govardhan Puja ceremony, you ate stacks of rice. In comparison to that, this small quantity is not even a morsel for you.
Yeah. Tumita Ishwaramo ek Shudra Jeeva Chara.
Tumita Ishwaramo ek Shudra Jeeva Chara.
Eka Grasa Madhukari Karaha Angikara.
You are the Supreme Personality of Godhead, whereas I am a most insignificant living being. Therefore, please accept a little quantity of food from my house.
Yeah.
A sannyasi is expected to collect a little food from each and every householder.
Madhukari, yeah.
That is to say, he should take whatever he required to eat. This system is called Madhukari. The word Madhukari comes from the word Madhukar and means honey collecting bees.
Yeah.
Bees collect a little honey from each flower, but all these small quantities of honey accumulate to become a beehive. Sannyasis should collect a little from each and every householder and should eat simply what is necessary to maintain the body. Being a sannyasi, Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu could collect a little food from the house of Sarvabhauma Bhattacharya, and this was the Bhattacharya's request. Compared to the food eaten by the Lord on other occasions, the Bhattacharya's feast was not even a morsel. This is what the Bhattacharya is pointing out to the Lord.
Etashani hasi prabhu vasila bhojane.
Etashani hasi prabhu vasila bhojane.
Jagannathera prasada vata dena harshamane.
Hearing this, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu smiled and sat down to eat. The Bhattacharya with great pleasure first offered him the prasadam from the Jagannath temple.
Hena kale amogha Bhattacharya जामाटा जामाता जनाटा एडता कोलीना निंदक ते हो शाटी कन्यार भरता
एट दिस टाइम द भट्टाचार्य सन इन लॉ अमोघा द हस्बैंड ऑफ हिज डॉटर शाटी अराइव्ड देयर ऑल्दो बॉर्न इन एन एरिस्टोक्रेटिक ब्राह्मणा फैमिली अमोघा वॉज अ ग्रेट फॉल्ट फाइंडर एंड ब्लास्फीमर
भोजन देखिते चाहे आसिते ना पारे लाठी हाते भट्टाचार्य आचे न दुयारे
Amoga wanted to see Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu eat, but he was not allowed to enter. Indeed, the Bhattacharya guarded the threshold of his house with a stick in his hand.
Therefore he was waiting there, you understand? See, the stick you saw there? In Bhattacharya's hand, how many of you are able to see the stick? Right hand. And here, who is this fellow? Amoga. He wanted to come and Bhattacharya is showing the stick to him. Don't come here. He wanted to, Amoga wanted to see Mahaprabhu eat. Why he wants to see Mahaprabhu eat? Because he's a fault finder and Deho yadi prasad dite haila anamana.
Deho yadi prasad dite haila
anamana. Amoga asi anna deki kare yenindana.
However, as soon as the Bhattacharya began distributing prasadam and was a little inattentive, Amoga came in. Seeing the quantity of food, he began to blaspheme.
Ehi anna tripta haya dasha vara jana. Ekela sanyasi kare yete ka bakshana.
This much food is sufficient to satisfy 10 or 12 men. But this sannyasi alone is eating so much.
Shunitei Bhattacharya ulati chahila. Tandra avadhana deki amoga palaila.
As soon as Amoga said this, Sarvam Bhattacharya turned his eyes upon him. Seeing the Bhattacharya's attitude, Amoga immediately left.
You know Bhattacharya will beat him up, huh? भट्टाचार्य लाठिलया मारिते धाइला पलायला अमोघतार लागन
पायला
द भट्टाचार्य रेन आफ्टर हिम टू स्ट्राइक हिम विथ अ स्टिक बट अमोघा फ्लेड सो फास्ट दैट द भट्टाचार्य कुड नॉट कैच हिम
तबे गाली शाप दिते भट्टाचार्य आयला इंदाशुनी महाप्रभु हासिते लागिला
इंदाशुनी महाप्रभु हासिते लागिला
द भट्टाचार्य देन बिगन टू कर्स हिज सन इन लॉ एंड कॉल हिम इल नेम्स व्हेन द भट्टाचार्य रिटर्न ही सॉ दैट श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु वाज लाफिंग टू हियर हिम क्रिटिसाइज अमोघा
शुनि शाटी रमाता शिरे बुके घाता मारे शाटी रांदी हाउ का यहा बले बारे बारे
When Shati's mother, the Bhattacharya's wife, heard of this incident, she immediately began to strike her head and chest, saying again and again, "Let Shati become a widow."
That means Amoga. Right. दुहार दुख देखी प्रभु दुहा प्रबोधिया दुहार ये चाते भोजन कैल तुष्ट हैया
Seeing the lamentation of both husband and wife, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu tried to pacify them. According to their desire, he ate the prasadam and was very satisfied.
आचमन कराया भट्ट दिल मुख वास
आचमन कराया भट्ट दिल मुख वास
తులసి మంజరి లవంగ ఎలా చిరసవాస
After Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu finished eating, the Bhattacharya poured water for the Lord to wash his mouth, hands and legs and offer him flavored spices, tulsi manjaris, cloves and cardamom.
Sarvange paraila prabhura malya chandana
Sarvange paraila prabhura malya chandana
Dandavat hayyavale sadainya vachana
The Bhattacharya then placed a flower garland over Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and smeared his body with sandalwood pulp. After offering obeisances, the Bhattacharya submitted the following humble statement.
This is the etiquette. Huh? First you serve the prasad, then you give him, as soon as the Vaishnava comes, you give water to wash his feet, then bring him in, give him a chatai to sit, then offer him the prasadam. After he eats the prasad, give him water to wash his hands and legs and mouth and And when he comes back, then you offer the garland, then you offer the chandan. That's the concluding part of the prasadam thing. Yeah. Ninda karayite toma aninu nijagare.
Ninda karayite toma aninu nijagare.
Yei aparada prabhu kshama karamore.
I brought you to my home just to have you blasphemed. This is a great offense. Please excuse me. I beg your pardon.
Prabhu kahe ninda nahe sahaja kahila. Ihate tumara kiba aparada haila.
Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, What Amogha has said is correct. Therefore, it is not blasphemy. What is your offense?
ఏతవలి మహాప్రభు చలిలా భవనే భటాచార్య తార ఘరే గెలా తారసనే
ఆఫ్టర్ సేయింగ్ దిస్ శ్రీ చైతన్య మహాప్రభు లెఫ్ట్ అండ్ రిటర్న్ టు హిస్ రెసిడెన్స్ సర్వం భటాచార్య ఫాలోడ్ హిమ్
ప్రభు పదే పడి బహు ఆత్మనిందా కైలా आरे शांत करी प्रभु घरे पठाइला
फॉलिंग डाउन एट द लॉर्ड्स फीट सर्वम भट्टाचार्य सेड मेनी थिंग्स इन सेल्फ रिप्रोच द लॉर्ड देन पेसिफाइड
मींस ही वाज कर्सिंग हिमसेल्फ बिकॉज़ आई ब्रॉट यू टू माय होम एंड यू नो अमोघा ब्लास्फेम्ड यू वाज फीलिंग वेरी पेन देयर
द लॉर्ड देन पेसिफाइड हिम एंड सेंट हिम बैक टू हिज होम
या गारे आसी भट्टाचार्य शातिर मातासने आपना निंदिया किचु बले न बचने
आफ्टर रिटर्निंग टू हिज होम सर्वम भट्टाचार्य कंसल्टेड विथ हिज वाइफ द मदर ऑफ शाटी आफ्टर पर्सनली कंडेमिंग हिमसेल्फ ही बिगेन टू स्पीक एज फॉलोस
चैतन्य गोसाईर निंदा सुनिल यहा हैते अरे वद कैल कैले हय पाप प्रायश्चिते
इफ द मैन हु ब्लास्फेम्ड श्री चैतन्य महाप्रभु इज किल्ड हिज सिनफुल एक्शन मे बी अटोन द हरि भक्ति विलास साइट्स द फॉलोइंग कोटेशन फ्रॉम द स्कंद पुराण कंसर्निंग द ब्लास्फेमिंग ऑफ अ वैष्णव
यो हि भागवतं लोकं उपहासं नृपोत्तम करोति तस्य नश्यन्ति अर्थधर्मयशस्तुताः निन्दां कुर्वन्ति ये मूढा वैष्णवानां महात्मनां पदन्ति पितृभिः सार्धं महारौरव संहिते हन्ति निन्दन्ति वै द्वेष्टि वैष्णवान् नाभिनन्दति क्रुध्यते यातिनो हर्षम हर्षन दर्शने पतनानि षट
इन अ कन्वर्सेशन बिटवीन मार्कंडेय एंड भागीरथ इट इज सेड माय डियर किंग वन हु डिराइड्स एन एक्सॉल्टेड डिवोटी लूजेस द रिजल्ट ऑफ हिज पायस एक्टिविटीज हिज ऑपुलेंस हिज रेप्यूटेशन एंड हिज सन्स वैष्णवास आर ऑल ग्रेट सोल्स हुएवर ब्लास्फेमिंग देम फॉल डाउन टू द हेल नोन एज महारुर्व एकंपनीड बाय हिज फोर फादर्स Whoever kills or blasphemes a Vaishnava and whoever is envious of a Vaishnava or angry with him or whoever does not offer him obeisances or feel joy upon seeing him certainly falls into a hellish condition. Also the Hari Bhakti Vilas.
Yeah, that is the Hari Bhakti Vilas quote as is given. Nindam kurvanti ye papa Vaishnavana mahatmana. If somebody is doing offense to a Vaishnava, Yama shasanehi, he will be punished by Yama.
In a conversation between Prahlad Maharaj and Bali Maharaj, it is said, those sinful people who blaspheme Vaishnava, who are all great souls, are subjected very severely to the punishment offered by Yamaraj. In the Vedic literature, we find the following statements concerning the blaspheme of Lord Vishnu and his devotees.
Actually, it's a long verse. See, it's a big verse. Read this translation.
Those who criticize Lord Vishnu and his devotees lose all the benefits accrued in 100 pious births. Such person rot in the Kumbhi Paka hell and are bitten by worms as long as the sun and moon exist.
My Lord, long period.
One should therefore not even see the face of person who blasphemes Lord Vishnu and his devotees. Never try to associate with such persons.
Then Bhakti Sandharva is quoting, Jiva Goswami quotes from Srimad Bhagavatam. Same verse. Yeah. This is spoken by Lord Shiva, Shiva's wife Sati. Srimad Bhagavatam. Yeah, they're cutting their tongue and all that. You read this one?
If one hears an irresponsible person blaspheming the master and controller of religion, he should block his ears and go away if unable to punish him. But if one is able to kill, then one should by force cut out the blasphemer's tongue and kill the offender. And after that, he should give up his own life.
Difficult, no? So out of this, which is easier, feel? You block your ears and run away from that place. Or one should cut the blasphemer's tongue and die yourself also on the spot. Basically, one should not hear the offense. Actually, what happens by this kind of hearing, listening honestly to the offenses spoken against a Vaishnava, you will lose faith in that Vaishnava, you will become weak-minded, and this blasphemy will choke your ability to chant with quality. For example, somebody tells about ex-devotee, you don't know. You are having a big opinion about ex-devotee, and somebody comes and tells you how ex-devotee has no character, he has this problem, that problem. Because everybody holds perceptions. And if you faithfully hear about the ex-devotee, after that fellow goes away, blasphemer goes away, then whenever you look at the ex, what will come? Those blasphemy will come. So you will be not be able to respect them anymore. Then when you see them, you will say that I don't want to be guided by him. So he is this, he is that. Then people turn their face away. So honestly hearing from a blasphemer, like Kaikeyi honestly heard from Mantara, she got into trouble right now. Kimva nija prana yadi kari vimochana. Duji yogya na hai duji sharira brahmana.
Sarva matajar continue. Or if I give up my own life, this sinful action may be atoned. However, neither of these ideas is befitting because both bodies belong to brahmanas.
Punah sei ninda kera mukha na dekiva. Parityaga kailun tara namala laiva.
Instead, I shall never see the face of that blasphemer. I reject him and give up my relationship with him. I shall never even speak his name.
Shati re kaha tare chadukas. Se haila patita. Patita haile varta tajite uchita.
Inform my daughter Shati to abandon her relationship with her husband because he has fallen down. When the husband falls down, it is the wife's duty to relinquish the relationship.
Purport. Read that.
Srila Sarvam Bhattacharya consider that if Amogha were killed, the killer would suffer sinful reaction for killing the body of a Brahmana. For the same reason, it would have been undesirable for the Bhattacharya to commit suicide because he also was a Brahmana.
A Brahmana cannot die like that, yeah.
Since neither course could be accepted, the Bhattacharya decided to give up his relationship with Amoga and never see his face.
Yeah.
As far as killing the body of a Brahmana is concerned, Srimad Bhagavatam 1.7.53 gives the following injunction concerning a Brahma Bandhu, a person born of a Brahmana father but devoid of Brahminical qualities.
Read that translation.
The personality of Godhead Sri Krishna said, a Brahma Bandhu is not to be killed, but if he is an aggressor, he must be killed.
Adhisavas says, Brahma Bandhu na hantavya. Atatayi vadaha hana hanaha. That's a verse, yeah.
Quoting from the Smriti.
Sridhar Swami is saying, Atatayi na. This verse comes in Bhagavatam only. Quotation from Bhagavatam. See here. It is also stated in Bhagavatam. You want to see the verse? These are the punishments. Yeah.
Cutting the hair from his head, depriving him of his wealth.
Who was deprived of the wealth?
Ashwatthama,
yeah.
And driving him from his residence are the prescribed punishment for the relative of a Brahmana. There is no injunction for killing the body.
Same
translation.
It went back to that, huh?
This.
No, the second time it has come.
Yes.
Huh?
Okay. Which this is one. Down one point. Just cutting the hair from his head.
Yeah, we read it. They have quoted it here also. Yeah. Yes.
As far as Sati, the daughter of Sarma Bhattacharya, was concerned, she was advised to give up her relationship with her husband. Concerning this, Srimad Bhagavatam.
Na patishta sasya na mochede samupeta mrityum. Is quoting that. One cannot be husband?
One cannot be husband if he cannot liberate his dependents from inevitable death. If a person is not in Krishna consciousness and is bereft of spiritual power, he cannot protect his wife from the path of repeated birth and death. Consequently, such a person cannot be accepted as a husband. A wife should dedicate her life and everything to Krishna for further advancement in Krishna consciousness. If her husband abandons Krishna consciousness and she gives up her connection with him, she follows in the footsteps of a
Dvijapatnis.
The wives of a Brahmanas who were engaged in performing sacrifices. The wife is not to be condemned for cutting off such a relationship. In this regard, Sri Krishna assured the Dvijapatnis in Srimad Bhagavatam. My dear Dvijapatnis, rest assured that your husbands will not neglect you on your return. Nor will your brothers, sons or father refuse to accept you. Because you are my pure devotees, not only your relatives but also people in general as well as the demigods will be satisfied with you. Transcendental love for me does not depend upon bodily connection, but anyone whose mind is always absorbed in me will surely very soon come to me for my eternal association.
Here is a very important point. If a husband is fallen, why should reject him, it says. But in the modern times, see, husband is not a devotee and Mataji is a devotee. She is 16 down there, she is initiated, she goes to temple, takes darshan, takes part in programs. Husband is not a devotee. Should she give him up? Husband is still drinking or smoking, eating meat and coming home and and I remember one family, husband was like that. And wife was a big devotee. In her house, she used to arrange a program where more than 100 people would come, long haul, and many, Vaishnavas would come for the program, weekly once. Husband wouldn't chant one round also, he won't chant. He was adamant. He had beard, mustache, and going here, there, traveling all over the world. So, one time, when this lady asked her spiritual master, that because my husband is not a devotee, he's not even agreeing, last 20 years I am devotee, he's not even chanting one round even now. And should I, just reject him and then keep my mouth shut or, divorce him so that I will not have to tolerate living with a non-devotee who is eating meat, drinking wine and coming. So, her spiritual master told her, no, you should not do that. he told her that, you see, is he stopping you from chanting? Is he stopping you from worshipping the Lord in the altar in your home? He has allowed you to make a big altar at home. Plus, he is not offensive to devotees. On the day of the program, sometimes the husband also would come and serve prasadam to everybody. He would just serve everybody a little bit. And he will wish everybody well. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. But he will not chant, he will not come to temple. But nobody can ask him to stop drinking, smoking and all. It was like that. So that spiritual master told her that he is protecting you materially and you try to help him spiritually. And you both go on. Because as a woman, you need shelter, he said. If you divorce him and be alone, then your situation will be vulnerable. The people in the world will not respect you because you have divorced him, number one. And also if you are living single, it's very dangerous nowadays. Somebody may come and attack the home. You need a masculine support. So you take him as a material support to you and then you give him spiritual support like that, he said. So now hear what it means here, giving up the husband. Even in the 7th canto, Prabhupada mentions there. Sometimes the husband may be deadly against Krishna consciousness. He would never allow the wife to chant, allow the wife to wear tilak, allow the wife to wear kantimala. He would never allow her to water tulasi. He is like a deadly enemy to Vishnu or Krishna. He would think that if she is becoming Krishna conscious, that means she is not worshipping me as a hero. Sometimes husbands have beaten up their wives. What all they have done. So then if the wife is seeing that she is being extremely tortured and she is not allowed to practice one round chanting also, then she may have to go and stay with her parents' shelter then. Because parents actually, such wives generally in many places, they don't divorce the husband, but they separate. And then go and stay with the parents to practice. But these are all extreme cases. You cannot generalize and say statement. Patincha patitam teje. This is a point mentioned.
When a husband is fallen, one's relationship with him must be given up. This is quotation from Smriti Shastra as stated in Srimad Bhagavatam.
Yeah.
संतुष्टालोलुपा दक्षा धर्मज्ञा प्रिय सत्यवाक् पतिं तु अपतितं भजेत्।
A wife who is satisfied, who is not greedy, who is expert and knows religious principles, who speaks what is dear and truthful and is not bewildered, and who is always clean and affectionate, should be very much devoted to her husband if he is not fallen.
Like this? This is a verse. Santushta, Alolupa, Daksha, Dharmajna, Priya, Satyavak, Apramata. One has all these things. Then Shuchi, Snigdha, Patim, Tu, Apatitam, Bajira. Like that husband she should worship, like that he says.
Sehi Ratre Amoga Kaha Palaya Gela. Pratah Kale Tara Vishuchika Vyadi Haila.
Okay, this is 266. This is going to require some. See, from 266 to 302 is a very important section where we have to discuss about Amoga's offense and how he was relieved from the offense. Very important section. We will take it in one class and we will conclude this chapter. So, from here begins how Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu delivered Amoga for only one reason, because he was connected to Bhattacharya. Actually, Mahaprabhu felt that Bhattacharya is repenting again and again, and is not able to come out of the pain, because he feels that Bhattacharya felt that he has offended him while eating the food. Mahaprabhu is not externally saying anything, but he is not able to take it. He is feeling that I am the host. I hosted the prasad for Mahaprabhu, and Mahaprabhu had to hear. It's like calling a person to home and blaspheming him, like that he feels. Cries repeatedly. So for pacifying him, that's one reason. For pacifying him, he delivered Amoga. Number two is Amoga you know, Mahaprabhu decided to deliver him because he's connected to Bhattacharya. So, and if he becomes devotee, Bhattacharya will be very happy. Is that idea? Mahaprabhu agreed. So I will not read this translation, we'll do it next time. 266. Srila Prabhupada ki aur Bhakta Vrinda ki.